Hey guys, so today I filmed this look with the Jaclyn Hill Morphe Vault Collection, and today I use the Ring the Alarm palette. I'm gonna start with swatches real quick, and I'll show you the colors that are comparable to the original Jaclyn Hill palette. Then if you wanna see how I got this look and my opinion on this palette, go ahead and keep on watching. All right, there's Ring the Alarm next to Jaclyn Hill palette. You can definitely see that there are some similar shades in this palette just because they're both warm toned. And now I'm gonna swatch Ring the Alarm. All right, this is Lolly, Rush. That didn't swatch very well. On Camera. Oof. Boom. Oh, that's pretty. Alert. Bomb Ass. Siren. Mugshot. Ugh. Framed. And Secret. On my pinky. I spread those apart so I can fit the other swatches in between. I'm gonna put Sissy from the Jaclyn Hill palette next to Lolly. Sissy has definitely more of a pink with a gold reflect, whereas Lolly is more of a corally red with a gold reflect. I think that Rush and Alert are pretty unique. They don't really have any dupes in the Jaclyn Hill palette just because these are more of like a true orange shade. I'm gonna put Queen next to On Camera. Queen from the Jaclyn Hill palette is definitely more of a like gold, whereas On Camera is more of a yellowy gold. I'm gonna put Firework from the Jaclyn Hill palette next to Boom. I think that Firework has a hint of more red and pink in it, where Boom is a little bit more brown. There's nothing in Jaclyn Hill palette that's similar to Bomb Ass, just because Bomb Ass is such like a bright, shimmery red. There is Cran Apple, but this is more like a burgundy, shimmery color. I'll just show you anyways. This is Cranberry. See how much darker that is? I'm gonna put Jax from Jaclyn Hill palette next to Siren. Those two are pretty close. Jax is maybe just a little bit deeper. I'm gonna put Pukey from the Jaclyn Hill palette next to Mugshot. Mugshot is definitely a little bit more orange, whereas Pukey is more Pukey. I'm gonna put Chip from Jaclyn Hill next to Framed. Yeah, Chip is more of like a cool tone, dark purple, so not that similar to Framed. And then I'm gonna swatch Mocha next to Secret. Mocha is definitely more of a cool tone brown, whereas Secret's more of a warm tone brown. And out of the two, I would definitely prefer Secret because I prefer those warm tone browns. My arm is like sore from holding it up, but... So there definitely are some somewhat similar colors in the Jaclyn Hill palette compared to the Ring the Alarm palette. I think the closest are like the Boom shade and Lolly, kinda. Other than that, like, I guess they're pretty unique. I hope these swatches are helpful, so let's get into the tutorial. Alrighty, who's ready for round three with the Jaclyn Hill Vault Collection? If you haven't seen my videos with the other palettes in the Vault Collection, I will link them up above and down below for you. I will have a whole playlist of them as well. And let's get into this. I'm gonna take Rush on a Sigma E40, and that's gonna go in my crease. And I'm just building up this color. It's kind of like a peachy orange, it's really pretty. And the shade is blending out beautifully. I'm gonna take Framed on a Sigma E25. I just have a little bit right on the tip there. This is giving me flashbacks of the Rockstar shade from the Bling Boss palette, so I hope I don't have the same problem with this purple as I did with that purple. All right, don't worry guys, this is blending out great. I'm gonna deepen it up kind of in the outer crease. Yes, this is how a purple eyeshadow should blend. I'm gonna go back to my first brush with a little bit more Rush on it and use that to help blend out the purple. I'm gonna take Alert on my E25, and I'm gonna bring that on my lower lash line. This color is so pretty, it's like a pumpkin-y orange. We go back to my first brush and just kind of diffuse out this color. I'm also gonna bring Alert in my crease just to kind of even everything out. These matte shades are so pigmented, it's great. I do kind of wish there was maybe like a lighter brown or like a lighter kind of yellowy shade to help blend out a little bit more, but that's okay. I'm gonna build up that purple Framed shade even more, just because I lost it a little bit. This purple blends beautifully. I'm gonna take Secret on a Sigma E36. I'm gonna add that to the very outer corner of my crease. This is like the most perfect warm tone dark brown. This shade is just what I need in my life. And I'm gonna add a little bit on my lower lash line. And then using my E25 to lightly blend. I'm gonna take the shade On Camera on an E56, and I'm gonna put that on the blank part of my lid. I'm usually not a big fan of gold eyeshadows, but this one is gorgeous. This palette also doesn't have any like light shimmery shades for a highlight color. I'm actually gonna go into the Bling Boss palette and I'm gonna take Bling Bling, and I'm gonna use that on a Sigma L04. I just feel like I have to have a highlight color. I'm gonna take that dark brown Secret color again on a Sigma E65. I'm just gonna pat that on my lash line as kind of like an eyeliner. All right, now I'm gonna pop on some mascara and lashes. So for lashes, I popped on House of Lashes and Natalia, and here's the final look. I am very happy and pleased with this palette, and the matte shades I used today worked perfectly. They blended great, especially that purple frame shade was beautiful compared to the purple in the Bling Boss palette. This is the purple in the Bling Boss palette, Rockstar, and there it is next to Framed. That's Rockstar from Bling Boss, this is Framed. I don't know what those are, but yeah. While I do think Rockstar is a prettier purple, Framed worked a million times better. I'm really excited about this Ring the Alarm palette. I can see myself using it a lot, and I could also see myself traveling with it if I didn't want to bring like the whole Jaclyn Hill palette with me. I just wish there was like a light shimmery highlighting shade and also a lighter transition blending shade, but other than that, I do love the colors in this palette and they worked really well. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to check out my other videos with the Vault collection, and I'll have another tutorial up tomorrow with the dark blue green smoky palette.